making friends. If your friends ask you to meet, you should say no. Home, we will immediately close all shops selling non-essential goods, including clothing and electronic stores and other premises, including libraries, playgrounds and outdoor gyms and places of worship. We'll stop all gatherings of more than two people in public, excluding people you live with. If you don't follow the rules, the police will have the powers to enforce shopping except for essentials like food and medicine. And you should do this as little as you can at any one time, so we can protect the NHS's ability to cope and save more lives. And that's why we've been asking people to stay at home. Emergency. To stay at home, protect our NHS, and save lives. Thank you.
23rd, a very reminiscent day for us, the general public, as it signifies 1 year on since we were put into the first UK lockdown. It was a strange and an odd time for us, the general public, because we've never faced anything like this before. Wear masks were mandatory, from where toilet roll was the new currency, to where clapping for the carers was for a mark of respect. Thursday, 8 p.m, we clapped for our carers to show a mark of respect in their tough times where they were working crucial hours to keep us safe. Now, as of the first lockdown, a lot of people were facing a lot of mental battles conquering their own adversities. So I went to TikTok, went on my live and asked a few creators what were their initial thoughts of lockdown one and how did they feel?
Well, when I saw the video leak of the guy falling over in China, I just thought, oh, here we go, another ridiculous story that's going to come out. And then it all just blew up, and for a long time I found it hard to get my head around it, and I was a little bit... I still in some ways think that the government are kind of milking this whole thing a little bit too much. But I was thinking it was all a little bit of a farce when it first came out.
Joke. Oh, mate, honestly, I felt like the first fucking pandemic, right? It was dealt very badly from the government. Like, they should have done so much better. You know, if you know what I mean, right? It was like, they should have locked people in a lot earlier and they should have kept it. Me personally, I felt like they should have kept the lockdown a substantial way till we had zero cases.
My initial thoughts on the first pandemic.
Yeah, first pandemic.
Okay, so my thoughts on the initial first pandemic, it would have been, I was kind of happy. Now, the reason is because I knew that it isn't going to go to a major problem. So, and I wanted to kind of... Okay, that sounds weird, but it's probably like a new adventure kind of thing.
Yeah.
It impacted me. Well, I lost my job in the first pandemic. I started doing a lot more live streams, you know, joining people and doing talent shows on Instagram. I started TikTok near the end of the year. And yeah, it just impacted
me. Oh. I don't know. I was just a bit like, I felt a bit like restricted on what I could do when I was bored. and it felt like it wasn't going to end. Like, it was just going on and on and on. Like, it didn't feel like it was going to stop. And obviously
it
didn't.
A joke. I don't really care, mate, because I'm with my missus, and we're just fucking having a great time, really, mate. Animal Crossing, bit of Switch, you know what I mean? It ain't really too much, you know. Susan's cooked me a bit of pizzas and that, you know what I mean? Mate, ain't that difficult for me, man. I know it's hard for me.
I felt confused. I felt frustrated. I felt worried. Like, how are we going to survive? How are we going to, you know, pay this, pay that, do this, do that. How am I going to make any money from music?
Very anxious. Like, anxious all the time, like panicking. Are we going to, you know, are we all going to lose our job?
I felt like absolute crap. But I was going through, like, a bad placement early last year anyway, so it didn't, like, help. But it did also help me sort myself out. Like, I managed to, like, sort out my weight.
A bit of self-love.
Yeah. Literally, at me time, quite a while, yeah.
No schools were open. The daily 9-to-5 was non-existent anymore. All the places were turned into ghost town. And we were contemplating whether this was the new norm. On this day, we looked into the abyss to consider that, are we going to get out of this sticky situation? But it's not going to be the same for another couple of months. We just need to cast our minds to May the 10th, the end of lockdown one. Just under 2 months since we were put into the first lockdown. Was this a sign for better things to come? This allowed you to go out for more exercise and the fact that you can sunbathe in the sunshine. Later, six people were allowed to meet outside the household. All these are coming together and we're thinking, is this the sign for something better? Are we going to return to normality? First, lockdown was eased. The freedom is coming back. 2 weeks later, June the 15th, things were opening up. We can go and get our hair cuts. We can go and visit hospitality industry and the leisure industry. And we thought, we're looking good, we're looking brilliant. But there was another twist in the tale. The test of easing the lockdown is quite profound in a worldwide scenario where the death of George Floyd rocked the whole world, where people were campaigning for Black Lives Matter. Face coverings became mandatory on July the 24th, which, you know, highlighted, is this our freedom getting stripped? Is it that we're going to have to live in a world where we have to walk around keeping our mouths closed by a piece of cloth? August the 3rd, 2020, signified a tough time in the British economy. We're looking at the first recession since 2009, and the Lord and Saviour, as you may produce, Rishi Sunak, introduced the scheme Eat Out to Help Out, which was a good attempt to try and boost the failing economy of the UK. However, September the 8th was not a good day. It was when the coronavirus cases were going up on the rise. The UK as a whole were looking back into the red, the danger zone, where we were looking at the start in March. Halloween, a scary time. We're going ahead a month and a half. 1 million confirmed lab cases were on our deals. And on the 31st of October, this led into our second lockdown, which was promised to last for 4 weeks, and it did. Let's cast now to December.
Start of December, you must stay at home.
On the first day of Christmas, Boris told the A175,000 death toll. Second day of Christmas, Boris told the a structured tier 4 system and a 175,000 death toll. The same day as the second day of Christmas, where he introduced the 4-tier system, was the day that we finished the 4-week lockdown, which was set on October 31st. Now, if you can imagine the 4-tier system as a wedding cake, as you can see on the screen now, there's a nice little wedding cake, quite scrumptious. And here we go. As of tier 1, it's the biggest piece. The bottom, that signifies you have got the most opportunities to do as much in specific guidelines. If you go up the cake, tier 2, you've got a bit less than tier 1, but you're still allowed to do more than the other two, tier 3, tier 4. Tier 3, not much has opened. Pubs were still open though, so you could have a nice beverage, and the bookies and gambling, and the gyms were still open, so you could get your work on and spend your money away. Whereas tier 4, you were stripped completely. It was like prior to the first and second lockdown. However, this tier system was reviewed every 2 weeks, and this signified whether you were going to a lower tier or a higher tier. People were being moved more than pieces on a chessboard, strategically planning the best and strategic way to try and get out of this sticky situation. However, a sad time in December is normally a good glittering time with presents and love from family. But big Boris Johnson, magical Matt Hancock, and the ugly fuck about his Christmas, he looks like this man here, told us Christmas is cancelled. McCauley calls his face. Happy New Year 2021. Are we looking good? I'll tell you right now, we are not looking good. It was a sign on January the 4th where we were put into the third, that's right, the third lockdown. We were getting fed up now. We just started a new year, and people say new year, new me. I started a diet, I started running. People started breaking lockdowns because they were fed up of being kept inside their freedom stripped.
While our vaccines are rolled out, in England, we must therefore go into a national lockdown, which is tough enough to contain this variant.
We thought, where are we going to go from here? It's January the 4th. We're not looking good. And we were thinking, this is not going to last the same as lockdown 1. It'll be a bit shorter than lockdown 2. But we were wrong. Throughout January to March, mass testing, where you've got the old cotton bud up the nose, twisty twisty on the tonsils, and it'll be put through a litmus test to see if you're positive or negative, where you have to say self-isolate 14 days. Mass rollout for vaccinations for the critical and the vulnerable. And we're looking more prominent to be on the better side of this. Now, a year on, March 23rd, 2021, a lot is the same. A lot has changed. We are currently, at the moment, in the process of getting to a better place. We're looking at April the 12th, gyms and a lot of leisure to be open. You can be able to get your haircuts again, look at the fringe, look at everything. you'll be able to have a normal life. Schools, secondary schools, colleges, everything was opening up. But is it going to be the case that, in the words of Yaz, is the only way is up, baby? Or in the words of Paul Johnson, are we looking like we're going down, 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 down?
I just want to say, hopefully you liked that video. And if you do, please like, subscribe. And if you want to see any more of that type of content, where we do a little documentary, feel free to put it in the comments. Hope you liked it. Much love. Stay safe. Protect yourself. Much love.